సార్ పేజ్ మీద వస్తుంది సార్ ఇప్పుడు ఒకసారి చెక్ చేయండి. సార్ అన్మ్యూట్ చేయండి సార్.
ఓకే, ఇప్పుడు నేను షేర్ నాది వస్తుందా స్క్రీన్? ఓకే. సో గుడ్ మార్నింగ్ ఆల్ ద స్టూడెంట్స్, వెల్కమ్ యూ ఆల్. దిస్ ఇస్ జస్ట్ అనౌన్స్మెంట్. దోస్ హూ మే నాట్ బి ఏబుల్ టు జాయిన్ జూమ్ ఆర్ దే గెట్ డిస్కనెక్టెడ్ అండ్ కాంట్ రీ ఎంటర్ దెన్ please use our Facebook page Smart Infrast Live. So that's the only way you can connect to us, because we have Zoom limitation of 100 participants, whereas we have more than 500 registrations. So this being the introduction session, we are clubbing everyone. So you bear with us today, and for the regular classes, we four batches divided. So depending on the option you choose, like planning engineer, supervising engineer, or design engineer, or detailing engineer, so then you will be having separate sessions every day. So for today, you have to attend through Facebook Live, because this is an introduction session. So, Bhaskar, is it clear? Bhaskar?
Clear, sir.
Okay, na, Sridhar?
Yes, sir, clear. Your voice is clear.
Sir, ఇది డబుల్ వాయిస్ వస్తుంది సార్, ఏదన్నా మ్యూట్ చేయండి.
అంటే ఫేస్బుక్ వాళ్ళు అంటారా డబుల్ వాయిస్?
ఫేస్బుక్ మ్యూట్ లో పెట్టండి. ఇప్పుడు ఓకే సార్.
ఇప్పుడు యా యాక్చువల్లీ ఐ షుడ్ కనెక్ట్ టు ఫేస్బుక్ భాస్కర్, ఎందుకంటే కానీ నాది రాదు కదా ఫేస్బుక్, నాది వస్తుందా? శ్రీధర్ బాబు
నౌ ఇట్స్ క్లియర్ సార్.
అంటే మీరు మొబైల్లో కనుక ఆన్ చేసి ఉంటే దాన్ని మ్యూట్ లో పెట్టండి సార్.
ఓ నాది, ఓకే ఓకే, ఐఎమ్ నాట్ ప్లేయింగ్ మై ఫేస్బుక్. సో ఐ హావ్ పుట్ ద
అనయ్య మళ్ళా చేస్తాను, మరలా చేస్తాను.
సో విల్ బి స్టార్టింగ్ అవర్ సెషన్ ఇన్ అనదర్ 3 మినిట్స్. భాస్కర్ జూమ్ ఇస్ ఫుల్ ఆర్ భాస్కర్ జూమ్
సార్
ఎంతమంది ఉన్నారు జూమ్ లో? జూమ్ లో ఎంత మంది ఉన్నారు?
జూమ్ లో 97 సార్.
ఓకే
97 సార్, 97.
ఓకే ఓకే.
హండ్రెడ్ సార్, 99 సార్.
ఓకే ఓకే. సో లెట్ అస్ స్టార్ట్ now. It's almost like 11 o'clock. Okay. Good morning all the students, we welcome you all for this summer internship 2021. First of all, we thank you for registering with Smart Infrast. And as we introduced, Smart Infrast is a trust. Basically, many people are getting doubt whether registering alone is enough or should they pay any more amount for the internship. Because it is a trust, it's not a commercial activity. The whatever registration fee we are taking is only to make you members of Smart Infrast, so that you are connected with this trust throughout your career also, even after completing your engineering. So the objective of the trust is to connect with all the civil engineers in our country. So we, Smart Infrast, started in 2015 by 7 engineers in Hyderabad, including me. And so Shekhar Reddy, who was president of CREDAI, and C.A. Prasad, who is president of Pre-Engineered Structure Society of India, for which I am also founder president. Mahendra Reddy, structural consultant and governing council member. He was governing council member of IA Structure. C.A. Rambabu, he is the managing director of CMEC, Construction Mechanization. Engineer Josna, who is also director in CMEC and trustee of our company. And Baba Dharmateja, he's a managing director of Galacon Infrastructure Company. So we have joined from various facets of our profession together to help civil engineers become better civil engineers and enhance employment and employability for the civil engineers. With this objective, we started this trust, and we are joined by our IT support, Bhaskar, who is also managing all this activity. So you should know about him. So anytime on IT dependent thing, Bhaskar is behind us, and he's with us for last 20 years. And Sridhar Babu, he's our vice president and also coordinating the training. And so please note his contact number I'm sharing here, so that if you have any queries on this program, training program. Engineer Sridhar Babu will coordinate. He's also with us for more than 10 years. So he is the backbone of our internship training program. So, and we are also, actually I am the founding director and managing director of Satyavani Projects and Consultants. So we are a consulting firm since 94. We are providing services all over India and did projects abroad also. So this is a background of the company with which you are interacting. So we have executed projects worth more than 10,000 crores. So in infrastructure, buildings, in planning, design, and project management. So I'm the managing director. Now it is 32 years in Satyavani, 27 years. So I'm postgraduate in structural engineering from IIT Madras and undergraduate from JNTU Kakinada. And we are also having executive directors, Engineer T. Srinivas, with 35 years of project management and facility management experience. And C.V. Subramaniam, also director designs with Satyavani, 27 years. And we have a chief architect with 46 years of experience, architect Gurnath Sirsi. And we have director projects, Karunakar, who is with us for almost 19 years now. And Ayanga, he is our design, structural design head. So he is with us for more than 4 years. And Ramakrishna, he heads our detailing team, structural detailing. He is with us for 20 years. So this is the team you are going to interact with for any queries and doubts you have. And this is our training program last year we conducted for experienced people. We trained about 400 people, 500 people on this planning, planning design, detailing aspects and the BIM also. So we offered 8 courses and 1 hour alternate days that time. So now the training that we are offering today is detailing RCC and junior design engineer, planning engineer and supervising engineer. So these are the 1, 6, 7 and 8 are the internships we are offering now. So these are the program contents. So first and foremost, important for all of you, I want to tell you is punctuality. Time, we should learn actually. Internship is a training life. So first thing we all have to learn is being punctual. 11 means better join 5 minutes before. So this is very important as far as we are concerned. So please be punctual. And there will be, of course, in case you miss by any chance, the recorded sessions will be available in YouTube. But those sessions will be available only for the registered people. And next is the assignments. This is very serious. Internship, very important aspect of our internship is this assignment. Your assessment will be based on your attendance. You have to prepare the notes of each of the session and you have to do this assignment work. These are practical problems that we share with you through these classes and you have to do. I keep getting queries from many of you that you don't have laptop or you don't have this software and all. Doesn't matter. We engineers have to work under any circumstances. Even if we don't have pen, paper, and light, still we have our mind, we have to use it and work. So engineering is all about giving solution, not about how we give solution, okay? So software, not essential, but problem solving is very compulsory. So you should learn, suppose analysis, we say you analyze this frame, that analysis you should do either by moment distribution or equivalent frame method, or you have to use any method, cantilever method, portal method, all this. And submit the assignment. Submission of assignment is important. You can write with your pen, on paper, take a photograph and submit also. But please submit in one booklet, like a PDF. Don't submit in JPG of each photograph. Please make notes of what I'm saying. I hope all of you are noting what I'm telling. Otherwise also, if you have not understood, this whole thing will be available in YouTube again. So you can refer to this lecture again to clarify any of your doubts. So problem solving is very important. So you have to submit the assignments in PDF format. Through WhatsApp groups, we have created 4 WhatsApp groups, like one for planning engineers, one for supervising engineers, one for design engineer, and one for detailing engineer. So these are the 4 WhatsApp groups. If you are not added, I have shared the number of Sridhar with you. Please share this number for those who would have missed in the beginning. So this is the contact number, 924622689. This is the contact number of our training coordinator, Sridhar Babu. So you can message him in WhatsApp and request him to add, if you have paid the registration fee and if you have already got the mail, but you have not got added in the WhatsApp group. So being in WhatsApp group is very important, and also having preferably Gmail ID is very important, because all these sessions will be shared through Gmail in YouTube. So you have to subscribe our YouTube channel, and you have to subscribe our Facebook page, Smart Infest, as mentioned in the email. So please join that and report in good, legible and presentable format. This is very important. We'll do the assessment of all your submitted reports, and we will conduct tests. You have to listen to all lectures repeatedly and prepare notes. And if you have any doubts, please join the sessions which I conduct every day for the coming 1 month. So anybody can join that session and ask me questions or doubts, whatever you have, I clarify. And through WhatsApp also, you can interact with us to clarify your doubts, and we will clarify, okay? And towards the end of this session also, I'll open for questions. And in Facebook also, you can post your queries. If they are not answered immediately also, after this session also, we'll answer individually or in the group the queries, all the doubts you have. So we don't leave you with any doubt. So that's our objective. So the objective of this whole training program is to bring in uniform standard processes in our engineering and documentation, learn documentation in civil engineering. You all have to study and attend to our lectures. We don't limit you to one session. If you are very keen and if you complete fast once one program, I'll give you opportunity to get into other also. Like you registered for planning engineer, but you are also interested in design. So once you complete all the 15 sessions of planning engineer and submit all the assignments, you suppose you finish it in 15 days, then I'll give you another 15 days design engineer access also. So that opportunity I'll give, because I want to encourage whoever is very good, whoever wants to pursue more knowledge in these sessions. Doesn't matter whether you are in second year, third year, final year, or M.Tech. All of you can attend this in the same group actually. But you do the assignment at your level. Don't worry about doing the best. But you should learn to do, answer these things. And the process you should understand. What is the design process? What is the planning process? What is the supervision process on the construction sites? Next is the documentation. We share all the documentation in Excel formats. Our idea is to students, if they learn this standard process, when you are working in your job in future, you should be able to follow this process. And a clear scope of work. That is, most of the engineers suffer and slog at sites or in the offices because they lack proper understanding of the scope of work. So what is design, what is planning, what is supervision, what is detailing? This is the total engineering cycle of the project. So we should learn that scope in each stage. Design stage, detailing stage, planning stage, and supervision. So here we have detail, prepare the drawing, design, model it, plan, and execute. This is the cycle of the project. What we detail, suppose we understand the requirements of the people, what they want to build, a constructed facility. Then we will try to draft the design intent, we call. We prepare the design intent, and from the design intent, we go to the design basis. And from the design basis, we go to the loads and modeling of the structure. And then we go for the analysis, we go for the design, and we go for the detailing, drawings, preparation of the drawing. From the drawings, you make the estimate, plan the execution by scheduling the timelines and all, and then issue to the construction site, contract and all, and then issue to the construction site where you will be ready for execution of the project. Next, our objective also is to earn respect for engineers by engineers first. Why engineers are ill-treated by engineers themselves is, suppose you join a job, your boss will ask you, how many inches per feet? Suppose you can't answer, then are you an engineer? You are ill-treated. So you should be ready with all this knowledge. Basic fundamental thing is units of measurement. The feet, the acre, the square yard, the square meter, the hectare, the centimeter, the millimeter, and feet, inch, all these conversions also, cross conversion. Because in India, most of the clients, they understand, and masons, they understand feet, inch and only. And I also agree, marking on site with feet and inch is easier than mm and centimeter. But for submissions online, drawing, we have to do it in mm. This is the biggest challenge for engineers. So if it is 3000 mm, if you ask me to convert to feet, if it's not 10 meter, it's not 10 feet. 10 feet is 3048 mm. So for it to make it exact, it is 9 feet 10 inches. Even then it is not accurately 3000 mm. So that is the challenge for engineers. So we should know this conversion of units and requirements of the units of measurement, measurement of areas, cubic feet to cubic meter. These are all the very important aspects: kilonewton, ton, kg, newton, weights, and pound, even pounds. So these are all important you should learn. So in this period of internship, you try to be perfect in this. In fact, some of the people I have come across, they are struggling to even calculate moment of inertia, center of gravity, and what is this radius of gyration, section modulus. These are all the fundamental measurements in engineering. So you should all learn these things by the end of this 1 month training program. Next, mission of our Smart Infest is to bring all engineers onto same working platform. We must have uniform standards and raise the standards. First is make all uniform and then raise the standard, and a crystal clear scope, rigid the standards, be very rigid on the standards and processes. And engineers should respect engineering and engineers. Yesterday, somebody is asking me in our Facebook or WhatsApp group, one of the WhatsApp group. Suppose you have a column and beam junction, concrete, suppose beam is designed with M30 grade concrete, column is designed with M40 grade concrete. You can see in our Facebook page, yesterday I posted that conversation screenshot also in our Facebook page, Smart Interest. So what should be the grade of concrete at the junction? This is a column and this is a beam. So column should be uniform M40, no? And at the junction, you should always have higher grade of concrete. Why I'm explaining this is rigid standards. Never answer any question in engineering without referring to a standard, Bureau of Indian Standards or American Standard, ACI, or Eurocode. These are the codes which will define all these things. Otherwise, standard books or standard manuals of practice. So it's very important. So if we, all engineers talk in engineering standards, so we get the respect. There is nobody who, suppose when you talk without reference, without referring to code only, you will be ill-treated. That is my point. And of course, there are other psychological factors, ego and all. Let's not worry about it. But at least let all engineers come onto the same language of measurements, units, and standards. And then we have to enhance employability and employment for civil engineers. So if every work is done with the standards, we need more engineers actually. That is why we strive to make engineers more engineering, with more engineering actually. So you should learn everything in detail. And we want to connect with all the engineers. This is another attempt. One of the idea why we offer internships is we will connect with you young when you are in second year, third year, and we will train you, mentor you, hand-holding approach to make you better engineer in future, so that we will all connect with all the engineers with the same standard. And we unite. When we are united only, we will have better opportunities. We can enforce our requirements. Just a minute. Good morning, how are you? Yeah, I'm in Facebook Live. You can also join if you want. Sorry. So unite all the engineers for better employment and employability. So the program, now we are coming to this program details. This program is, sorry, I'm not able to see. Okay. 15 hours is the contact course, contact with you, and followed by everyday 3 hours of working. You must, this is minimum I am specifying, but you should spend more time. So 1 month is the duration, and please, this is for detailing of RCC elements. You should have access to SP34. Those who don't have can request me. I'll share the PDF of this SP34 detailing requirements. Next is IS456. IS456 also gives you the detailing requirements. This is the code for design and detailing of reinforced cement concrete. And next is the IS13920. This is also important. You should all learn. So 13920 is the code. And we should know about bar diameters available, bar lengths available, and lap lengths as per the standard, stirrups, hanger bars, spacers, chairs, rings, ties, spiral reinforcement, extra bars, curtailment of the bars, bar spacing, minimum and maximum, minimum reinforcement, maximum reinforcement, span versus diameter of the bar, cover, grades of concrete, grade of steel. So these are all the aspects covered in detailing. And development length, transition for lap. When you have the laps, there is a transition. Like if you have a 25mm bar for the lap to continue, what is the transition and safe bearing capacity, excavation detailing, plain cement concrete thickness, sand layer, plumb concrete, soling, dry packing, minimum concrete dimensions, grouting, bundled bars, and then drawing standards. This is another thing. We have an Indian standard for drawing standards also. Please refer to that standard: sheet size, pen size, stencil, scale of the drawing. What are the standard scales? 1:10, 1:20, 1:50, 100, 200, 400, 1000, 2000, like that. So title block size, what should be the size of the title block? Lisp proteins for the drawings in AutoCAD software, and AutoCAD exposure you need, and hands-on RCC slabs, that is detailing of the slabs. Two-way slab, one-way slab, flat slab, flat plate, waffle slab, all these things, and bar bending schedule. Next is the beams, reinforced cement concrete beams. So we have the continuous beams and single span beam, and we have deep beams, we have the grid beams, and then hands-on columns, RCC columns, RCC foundations, because you have a lot of types of foundation. We have one and two, and retaining wall. What is the retaining wall? And staircase, types of staircase, water tanks, flooring, lintels, chajja, reinforced cement, RCM walls, mortar, reinforced cement mortar, and drawings, quality checks. Ultimately, whatever drawing detailed and made, it has to be checked. So checking standard and bar bending schedule preparation. You have to prepare the bar bending schedule to estimate the steel requirement in the each drawing. So that is another important thing. Next is the junior design engineer. Actually, this was the course for experienced people, but here it is 15 hours training, again 1 month duration. And if you complete again in this, we cover in 15 hours, we cover the reinforcement concrete. If you have completed fast in 15 days, then we'll give you another 15 hours also. So always we keep the doors open for those who are hungry, who have appetite to learn more. We always allow you to do it, okay? There is no restriction. You can always message us, yes, I have completed 15 lectures, so please open the other 15 for me. So we'll do that. Next is the preparation of design brief, earthquake, wind, live load, dead load, superimposed dead loads, fire tender, including codes, reference books, exposure, schedule of drawing, soil report, that is soil investigation report or geotechnical investigation report, clay, deep foundations, normal, soft disintegrated rock and hard rock, water table, survey, topographic survey, boundaries, neighboring structures, underground utilities, open well foundations and or wells in the site covered in survey. Slope ground, retaining for cut, fill, and architectural drawing framing plan. So this is the first part of this design engineer. So loads, yield line theory for the slabs loading, and based on that, the load distribution to the beams or walls, partition loads, floor finish, like flooring, all that, and terrace weatherproofing course, services, floor trunks, and sunken floor trunks means the cabling and all that, sunken filling, landscape, parking, fire tender, parking loads, fire tender movement, that means for the fire safety, and machines, diesel generator, transformer, lift machine room, water tanks, escalators. You see the escalators in the building. So all that, auditoriums, quasi-static, seismic. I'm sure this will look heavy for second year people. Don't worry. Just try to calculate the loads. That's enough in this assignment for second year. Third year, do a little more. Final year, do complete. So that is how you please follow. And analysis methods, we have 2D methods like moment coefficient method, moment distribution method, tributary area method for calculating the column loads, factor method, portal method, cantilever method. These are all explained here. And the preliminary analysis of the, so you can learn to do the analysis. Second year people, just learn the tributary area, that is enough. you need not even do factor and all this. Just do tributary area. That is simply calculating the area, multiply with the load, and multiply with the floors, you get the column load. That's enough. And the next 3D modeling of the structures and analysis using STAD. For second year, people learn to like a video game. You just open the STAD, do some model, just a portal frame, enough. And ETAPS also, just put two walls and slab, enough. In the ETAPS, like you can play games, you can do this analysis, you learn this. And the design of RCC slabs, balconies, sunken slabs, and the recess in the slabs, ducts, openings, buried pipes, long-term deflection calculation. These are all things you have to learn. And at least get exposed to all this, so that when you attend the classes in your college, you will know what is the importance of it in practice, okay? And design of beams, simply supported, fixed beams, continuous beams, beams resting on walls, cantilever beams, brackets, corbels, overhang beams, long spans and deep beams, T-beams, L-beams and I-beams, I-girders, openings in the beams, grid beams, stepped beams, secondary beams and long-term deflection. So many things are there. So design of columns, short column, long column, uniaxial bending, biaxial bending, ties, and IS 13920, IS 1893 also you should know, interaction curves, and design of footings, isolated eccentric footings, shoe footings, combined raft, lift well, UGSAM, pile cap. So design of flat slabs, direct design method, punching shear, and four edges, three edges, two edges. So these are the possible edges in the column support, and equivalent frame, plate modeling, drop panel, provision of drop panel, column head, column capital, and deflection checks in the flat slab. Design of post-tension slabs. This is a little bit more for second year people, but final year and MTech people can do this. And vendor drawings, pore strip study, and anchorage zones. And design of floor, because nowadays, you can't work in a site. Most of the buildings people are using post-tension, that is post-stressing of the cables, you know, more than next stage of the reinforcement. And design of flooring and grade slab, slab on grade, drains. Most of the people think that the flooring doesn't require design, but concrete flooring, even if it is resting on the soil, it requires design. Please remember, it's very important. So you should learn to do the design of this grade slab or slab on grade, drains, plinth beam, lintels, chajja, brick masonry. Masonry also, everybody thinks that masonry means mason's work. No, masonry is engineer's work. So we should design masonry also. So these are all explained in this session. So next is the planning engineer. So planning engineer also is a 15 hours training, plus followed by, each hour is followed by 3 hours of working. That means you'll have a total of 60 hours, very intense work to be done. For some people, 3 hours may not be adequate. You spend 6 hours or even 8 hours, it is important. So all 30 days together, whoever can spend 10 hours a day, I'll give special recognition. You prove to me that you have spent 300 hours in these 30 days, I'll give you a special recognition. Please note, Sridhar Babu, please keep it in mind. Whoever can prove, give a proof that he has worked for 300 hours, we'll give a special recognition to that candidate, okay? And drawing study, here, the first session is drawing study. You should understand how to study the drawing. And pre-bid, preparation of pre-bid drawings, schedule of drawings, architectural, civil and structural, mechanical, electrical, plumbing, air conditioning, firefighting, infrastructure like roads, drains, stormwater drains, and layout of the building plan, schedule of items. That means what are all the execution, excavation. Like when you do the excavation, you should store the excavated earth so that you should do the backfill. So all that schedule of items, leveling, grading of the site. Sometimes site is having undulation. You have to make it level. So that becomes an item. So you should, there are in excavation itself, there are 20, 30 schedule of items. So you should know what are all those schedule of items, where to use in planning for the doing the costing estimation and preparation for a drawing study for independent house, still plus five apartment and large project. All three is explained here in the first session. Next is the quanti survey, plintharea method, line estimate, preliminary estimate, detailed project report, technical sanction, bid, the BOQ. Everybody is asking what is there in the planning engineer. In fact, we have a very high number of registrations for planning engineer. So we'll definitely focus on this. Bid BOQ, unit quantity method, and BOQ by consultant. So these are all the things are explained. Today I'm not giving you details. I'm just showing what planning engineer means, what all he has to do. Drawing study, quantity survey, and costing. Lead means distance from which, suppose I am doing a project in Hyderabad, I have to get marble from Rajasthan. So what is the distance? What is the cost of transportation? That is called lead. Source of materials, labor, labor, material, and plant and machinery, LMP. This is a method of costing actually. So we have costing, rate analysis given in the book. So we have to know how many people are required to execute each activity, whether it is concreting, shuttering, rod bending, all that. And the cost plus method is another model. We estimate the entire cost, overheads and profit, instead of adding 15% like that, we do the cost plus model, actual cost. And a budget based design estimate, standard schedule of rates. Every state has got a SSR, and CPWD has got different schedule of rates. Non-schedule means there are items which are not covered in this SSR and CPWD. Market analysis, that means we do the market inquiries and do the estimation. MES, Military Engineering Services, NHAI, like Ministry of Surface Transport, MOST, or MORT, Ministry of Road Transport and Highways. And overheads, taxes, like estimation of taxes. Railways again has got different method of costing. Statutory insurance, workman compensation, contractor all risk policy, professional indemnity, and consulting. So these are all the so many items are there in planning engineer. So planning engineer connects the design and the implementation. In between is the planning. Many people ignore this, but it's a very important. And next is the construction engineering. It deals with buildability, constructability, shuttering design, Maiwan, conventional, plywood, steel, posts, supports, across spans, adjustable cross spans, adjustable prop supports, APS, drop head system, tunnel form, table form, large panels, formwork, doka system, staging design. So you should understand have the understanding of all the construction methods. Like you see the metro projects nowadays, segmental construction, there is a launching order, all that comes under construction engineering. Equipment, batching plant, concrete pumps, brick making, vibrators, earth moving machinery, excavators, graders, platforms, earth ramming, rollers, etc. Next is the handling. Hoist, builder's hoist, tower cranes, bobcats, movement, earth moving machinery, conveyors, trolleys, tippers, and transport. So these are all the items covered under handling. Next is the mix design and materials. What are the types of materials, specification of the material? Aggregates, cement, steel, joinery like windows, doors, bricks and blocks, plumbing, sanitary, electrical, firefighting, lighting, structural steel, sample room at the site. And resource planning, shuttering gang like carpenters, fitters, skilled workers, scaffolding design, staging design, and centering design, and mock-ups, flats or hotels, we do the mock-up rooms and scheduling activity, sequence, milestones, long lead items, and cycle time catch-up. Cycle time means if you want to do a 20-storied building, each floor, how long it will take? That is called the cycle time. 1 month, 15 days, 7 days, 3 days. If you can do in 3 days, that means 20 floors, you should complete in 60 days. And if you have two staggered, maybe it will be completed in 90 days, like that. So investigation, soil, topographic survey, and geotechnical investigation, pollution control board, that means environment impact assessment, traffic studies in case of transport projects, and then water feasibility, water availability, water feasibility, and power, all this will come under the investigation. And the checklist we have. Next is the site enabling. So even before construction starts, site should be ready for providing office, labor camp, stores, storing the materials, yards for storing the materials again, labor movement, transport of the labor, power availability for construction, water availability for construction, access to site, security, barricading, surveillance, CCTV, communication, workshop, batching, and equipment, transport, mock-up, QC lab. All this comes under site enabling. So it will all be explained there. And quality plan, registers, testing, quality control lab, methods, what are all the testing equipment we should provide at the site? So in your labs, in your college, you will know, so you'll correlate those things. Method statements, makes, product numbers, quality assurance, quality control, quality audit, quality vigilance. So many quality things we'll explain here. Codes and tolerances, technical specifications. Next is the safety plan, personal protective equipment. Now people understand what is PPE very easily thanks to Corona. And working plan and monitoring machinery. Procurement, lump sum, design build contracts, and engineering procurement, construction contracts, item rate contract, labor contracts, cost plus contract, unit rate contracts, material supply, pre-qualification, vendor registration, bidding, and a contract document. So this is the general conditions of contract, special conditions of contract, technical specification, schedule of items, schedule of drawing, arbitration clause, and escalation. So this is about the planning engineer. Next is the supervising engineer. In fact, this is more detailed, you can see here. Everybody thinks supervising engineer, what is the job? What is the role? So here we are explaining, supervising engineer has to prepare daily work plan. So we have a process document which we'll share, and works categories, work front, sequence, time requirements for activities, machinery and equipment plans, worker deployment and supervision plan, material shifting, transportation reference, previous day lag, and updation of site, display and labor, progress, machinery. I tell you, unfortunately, those who are recruited, for jobs on site, they are not trained in detail. That's why most of the engineers suffer a lot. So that's why I thought I must create the clear scope for supervising engineer. So all these aspects are explained. And the reports preparation, daily labor report, daily progress report, weekly progress report, monthly progress report, dashboard. Nowadays, online, we create the dashboard, minutes of meeting, request for information, contract letter preparation, statement of case for variation in the items, taking over the site, commencement date of the contract, closing, handing over deviations, specification drawings, quantity, follow-up of quantities as per the drawing and as per actual site condition, methods of execution, schedule of drawing, revision in the drawing, RFI for excavation, filling, formwork, reinforcement, concrete, soil conditions, specifications, architectural, flooring, finish schedule, joinery, boundary, survey, disposal of surplus earth, reuse of excavated earth, rock type, types of rock, slope protection, dewatering, construction loads, cover to reinforcement. In fact, I have seen there are less number of people for supervising engineer. In fact, supervising engineer is more challenging job. I request some of you to migrate to supervising engineer. Similarly, detailing engineer also. Detailing also is very important. Probably I spend more time on detailing and supervising so that you can join and utilize my experience in these two aspects. Anti-termite treatment, waterproofing, clarity in drawings, details in drawing, revision in the drawing, and cover to reinforcement, construction loads, dewatering, slope protection, all this. Method statements. Survey has got a method statement. Marking, soil investigation, excavation, anti-termite treatment, plain cement, concrete, reinforcement, formwork, concreting, pour sequence, dewatering, masonry, plastering, waterproofing. All this have got a method statement. How to construct masonry, how to do the plastering, how to do waterproofing, how to do weatherproofing. Painting also has got a method statement. Curing, flooring, compound wall. Everybody think compound wall doesn't require design, but compound wall also requires design, proper engineering. Parapet wall, railing, doors, windows, lintels, chajas, plumbing. Everything is challenging, I'm telling you. You should learn all this. And the quality control, materials, source, brand, specification, supplier testing, sampling, storage, shelf life, handling, workmanship, in-process finishing, raw water, raw materials, coarse aggregate, fines, reinforcement, tying, cover blocks, brick block. So these are all the things covered. Quality registers. So compliance report is also quality compliance. Non-compliance and NCR we call it, non-compliance report. Acceptance test, stage passing, snag list. So work markup compliance, material sample compliance, shade of the materials, color of work and surface color, surface finish and color of this material, all this. Next is the quality registers, drawings, hindrance, drawings register, hindrance register, materials received and consumption register, quality testing, sampling requirements, consumables, material, machinery use, diary of works, test results, and acceptance. This is a very, very important. And chemicals and special require materials consumption, inspection and audit requirements of machinery, levels record, dimension record, audit and vigilance. So these are all the things covered in quality register. I'm telling you, you have to prepare reports for all this. Every lecture followed by assignment is there, so you should follow that. And if you have any doubts, you can ask me or your coordinators. And drawing study, good for construction, schedule of drawings, architectural, civil and structural, public health engineering, electrical, air conditioning, and firefighting, building automation, external services, boundary wall, roads, arboriculture, that means plants and all. Landscaping, landscaping means how you make the land, grading and all that, and water supply storage, substation, street lighting, security, good for construction drawing. Revision shop drawings. Shop drawings is each part of the building we have to detail. Bargaining schedule, contract drawings, working drawing, general arrangement drawings, numeration details like formwork and all, formwork drawing, excavation drawings, ATT drawings, waterproofing drawing, finish schedule, dimensions, general notes. So these are all the things you should know. Next is the billing MBooks and a survey marking, formwork plan, construction planning. This is in two parts, like because you have to prepare the schedule and all. Contract management, earnest money deposit, initial security deposit, further security deposit, bank guarantees, fixed deposits, insurance, all this. Implementation, contract management, and administration, signing authority. It's a very, very detailed, I tell you, supervising engineer. and change management. So site change, drawing change, scope change, specification change, brand of material change, and product change, method of execution, finish change, shape change, quantity change, and time or extension on account of situation, all this. Finally, safety. Safety at work. So PP and methods of this one. So working condition, workmen, working condition safety, and health, environment, protection, prevention, fall arrest, access, lighting, ventilation, visibility, staging platforms, walkway, staircase, railing, barricade, deep excavations, working at heights, eye protection, feet protection, equipment, machinery usage manuals, tools and appliances, electrical cables, cameras and monitoring, surveillance, security and access control. So these are all the items covered in this supervisory. So expected outcome after training. The candidate, once completed the course, is expected to be ready to work for the industry. Of course, not second year people, but at least third year people. Final year project also you can select based on this. And the candidate will be trained to prepare a detailed drawing in one to two courses depending on the course chosen. Junior design engineer is the category of for assisting the structural design engineer and will be ready to model and prepare the design reports at the end of the course. And course three will help engineers to be able to take a planning engineer job in construction companies, design offices, PMC, project management consultant, or construction management consultant at site or office. Course four will prepare engineers to be able to take up supervising engineer job or internship positions on site. And then final test and certificate will be provided based on test and assignment submissions. So please note, you have to do assignment submissions every day. Whatever daily work you have done, you please make one PDF and submit. And a placement guidance based on test outcome will help you if you are looking for placement, depending on your hard work and presentation skills, communication skills will help you. So thank you, Bhaskar.
Sir.
All participants are there?
Yes, sir.
Please share that WhatsApp group. Okay. Now the chat box I'm seeing. I don't have SP34. Okay. We'll share that once you join the team. And Bhaskar, now you can open all. I request each one of you, we'll give permission for audio. We'll request you to open, unmute one at a time and ask questions or raise your hand. We will answer your queries. You can also put on video and audio and ask questions. Bhaskar?
Sir, already permission.
Yeah, you are given the permission. One by one, please ask questions. Any doubt on this program? Yeah, Patel, Harsh Patel, you can ask. Please put
yes,
on.
Sir.
Yeah.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. My question is, CAD engineering is same as detailing engineering, sir?
Pardon?
Sir, you explain about CAD engineering, but not explain about detailing engineering.
No, that is detailing only, actually. That's a different. Detailing only. CAD engineer is detailing only.
Okay, sir. Sorry, can we get chance to change any option as option to planning engineer or?
Yeah, you can.
Something
you can send
want to change.
Yeah, you can change.
Okay, sir. And another doubt is how many hours per day, sir? How many hours per day, sir?
Interaction will be 1 hour. That will be okay, the time. Sir. We'll communicate in the WhatsApp group.
And, okay, sir. Tanmay,
you are unmuted. You unmute when you are asking question only. Okay, Harsh Patel. So you can change your 1 hour will be fixed time. We'll intimate in the WhatsApp group. Each group every day there will be alternate day. There will be 1 hour lecture yes, by sir. Me. And so assignment you can do at your convenience.
Okay, sir. Okay, sir. No problem, sir.
There are many people in the waiting room. I request them to attend on Facebook Live only. Because
we are
already full. Yeah. Any other questions?
You can. So how we have to submit our assignment and where?
You can submit to the coordinator, Pratik. The coordinator Sridhar Babu is there. So you can submit through WhatsApp or email.
Okay, sir. Thank you, sir.
Okay. Any other questions?
Sir, you told that. Sir.
Yeah, Abhishek.
Hello, can you hear me?
Yeah.
Yes, sir. You told that we can switch a program after 15 days if we complete a course.
Yeah.
But you told alternate days you'll be taking the lectures.
Yeah, they're all available, recorded in YouTube. So you can complete early only if you listen to YouTube lectures recorded.
Okay.
We'll give you the link. Suppose you registered for planning engineer, you will be given the link. Yes, so there is no time limit. You can attend any number of lectures in that planning, for example, and finish early all the assignments and submit them. And then inform us, we'll conduct test and open another channel for you. Okay.
Yes.
So there is no limitation as such.
Yes, sir.
We'll encourage people going for more activity actually. Any other questions? From Facebook also, let me see. Any questions? How do we know? If you have any questions in the Facebook page, you can put here, you can type, we are unable to join Zoom. Yeah, Zoom has a limitation as I told, and share PPT of syllabus. Yes, we will share in the WhatsApp group. Zoom will be good option, yes, but today only we are making you attend on Facebook. And so can you send us the PDF? Yes, we'll send. And how to register for the planning engineer? So you send a WhatsApp message to a coordinator. Coordinator's number I have already given, Sridhar Babu. Or you can even post in this Facebook query. You can do that. Any other questions? From Zoom class attendees, do you have any questions? Sujit, yeah, you can unmute.
Hello, sir.
Yeah.
Hello.
Yeah, Sujit, tell me.
Sir, how the lectures are conducted, sir, for planning
Zoom.
Engineering?
On Zoom only.
Sir, there is a 100% participants only, sir.
Yeah.
We are trying at 11 o'clock to join Zoom meeting. We can't join, sir.
Yeah, that's right. We will see. We'll plan that logistics regular classes. We'll do it on Zoom only. We'll try to accommodate everyone.
Okay, sir. Because, sir, this is a introduction part, na, sir?
Yeah.
Okay, sir.
Because introduction, everyone is there. In one lecture only. After that, we'll divide.
Okay, sir.
So, on which date first class is going to start? Somebody is asking. We will intimate in WhatsApp. And timings will be morning 10 to 12 and evening 5 to 7. That will be the timing. Any other questions? Yes, Sridhar Vali. You can unmute and talk.
Sir, yeah. Per day there is two sections, sir. Per day?
Pardon? No.
Per day there will be two sections.
No. For me, there will be two sessions. One day I'll cover detailing and planning. One day I cover design and this one, supervising in there, like that.
Yeah.
But for each one of you, alternate day, 1 hour will be there. And meanwhile, you can, we will share the link of each group, planning, supervising, so you can listen to the lectures online and then do the assignment and submit the assignments. That is the model.
Sir, for coordinator, we have to submit, sir.
Pardon?
For coordinator, we have to submit assignment, sir.
Yeah, correct. So total hours for planning engineer lecture is 1 hour per day, alternate days. For each program is like that. 1 hour, alternate day. Due dates for assignment is, it is better you complete first assignment before second class, actually. That is the advice from me. Don't keep postponing. You will not be able to complete. 1 hour lecture. And either it will be 10 to 12, 10 to 11, 11 to 12, two sessions in the morning. And evening, it will be 5 to 6 and 6 to 7. So it will be like that. We will schedule that slots depending on planning. We will intimate to you in the WhatsApp group. No, not mandatory to join both. Each one will be having one only. Should we join the class which we have selected while registered? Yes, that's right. You have to join the class for which you have registered. We can switch course. I have registered, but if I want to switch course, yes, you can change before Friday. So today itself you decide and I'll post it in the WhatsApp group or intimate the coordinator, they will change you the batch in which you have. Any other questions, queries? So, link of assignments, it is available. And it will be posted in the WhatsApp group. Yeah, Rahul, you have a question? Let me see in the Facebook if you have any questions. If you have not yet registered, actually the registrations we have closed. New registrations we are not accepting now. But whoever has already registered, they can interchange their, if they have opted for planning, they can change to the design or detailing like that. So please decide today only and intimate to the coordinator.
Hello, sir.
What is the schedule of planning in here? I'll decide. Hemant, we will intimate. Yeah, Sujit, you have any question?
Sir, what is the timing for planning engineers?
We will intimate by today. I'll schedule and send you. Let us have some interaction in WhatsApp.
Our college lectures are 10 to 3 o'clock, sir.
You are supposed to do internship during the holiday, no? I mean, vacation, actually. I thought this is the vacation period. I got many requests from many colleges to offer internship during this period. Yeah, if you can't attend live lecture, you will always have the recorded link. So you can attend to that recorded link at your convenience, okay? And still clear your doubts in the WhatsApp group. On Zoom, then it will be completed in total 30 days. Yeah, good question, Umesh Chandra. He's saying you have given alternate day schedule, so 30 days is the schedule. So you always have the option to listen to these lectures in YouTube fast. In 15 days, you can listen 15 hours and do the assignment. And if you have any doubts, you can ask me. Are you clear, Umesh? No, we will send you the YouTube link to your registered email ID. Only then you will get access to YouTube lectures. Okay? We'll send the link to, suppose you registered for planning engineer, you will get the planning engineer link. Yeah, Rahul, you have any question? Rahul?
अरे बात को अरे बात को मैं मन मालम
एनी अदर क्वेश्चंस सो होप ऑल द डाउट्स आर सर बट व्हाट अबाउट असाइनमेंट ऑल असाइनमेंट्स विल बी सेंट या दे आर अवेलेबल यू विल बी गिवन द असाइनमेंट इन वन गो इफ यू रिक्वायर First, we have to do design engineer, then planning engineer and detail. Yeah, in fact, you can do maximum two only in this period, 1 month. So don't aspire to do more than two, okay? In design engineer itself, we have two sessions, two modules. Yeah, it is explained in the class, YouTube class. ETABS, how to use ETABS, how to use TAD is explained, and we expect you also to practice on your own. We will show the basic details with the screen and all, it is there. Any other questions? We'll close in another 5 minutes if you don't have any other questions. As long as you ask questions, we will continue.
Hello, sir.
How we attend our course and on which platform? Zoom only.
So what type of assignment will be there?
Somebody is telling you no software. If you don't have software, you do manual design. You can do it. Jadav. Yeah. You have some question, Pratik?
Yes, sir. What type of assignment means there will be some type of questions or any type of problem solving?
No, they're all given in the assignment. Problems are given in the assignment. And yes, you will be explained how to do it also in the assignment.
Okay,
in the YouTube lecture.
Thank you, sir.
Okay. Any other questions? We have 5 minutes left, and Facebook also. Assignments are given practical problems. They are to make the drawing, to design, to analyze. It can be handwritten, preferably typewrite. If you don't have laptop or if it is difficult for you to typewrite, then you can handwrite, take a picture, make a PDF and send it. Somebody is asking, Samarth Gupta, if I want to learn both design and planning, which I should do first? In fact, I suggest people who are in the third, who are completing third year or final year only to join design. Others can join supervision or detailing. That is better. planning also, it second year people, I don't suggest join immediately planning. Even if you have joined, it's okay, but you have to work hard. No, we have, somebody's asking, are the YouTube lectures and live sessions same or different? There will be, we have YouTube sessions recorded available already for the entire course. But now, for the sake of this present internship, we'll have fresh lectures again. So both will be available in on YouTube. Present lectures and past lectures. So those who want to do it fast can use the past lectures and do it early. That's what I explained. Registrations are closed. Somebody is asking whether he can register now. Now registrations are closed for this session. Maybe if we have more next month again, we'll start.
Good afternoon, sir.
Good. If you allow many members or participants. Yeah, Zoom. We'll try to do that. More members. All four courses you can't do in 1 month. Somebody's asking whether you can join all four courses. You cannot join. Maximum you can do two courses in 1 month. Is the test having? Yeah. MCQ, no, you have to do the problem solving, not multiple choice. Test is going to be problem solving only. Now, somebody is asking, how can we change the to a different course? Now, today, you can put your request to change the course, we will change.
Hello?
Yeah, in planning, somebody is asking, in planning, is there a drawing included or just theory? No, you have to do the drawing also. You have to study the drawing and you have to make the drawing. You have to do the method statement. Yeah, Rahul, you have a question?
Yes, sir.
Yeah.
Sir, is there any order? First you have to learn design and then planning and then detailing.
No, they're all independent. You can do anything first and later something else.
Okay, okay, sir.
They're independent. They're not interdependent, okay?
Okay, thank you, sir.
Yeah. Can I get both of certificates? Yeah, somebody is asking if he has finished two courses in 1 month, will you get two certificates? Yes, we will give.
Sir?
Yeah.
I'm in second year. Which course do you suggest, sir? I've taken planning.
Yeah, planning you can do. Not a problem.
Because a while ago you said planning would not be...
Yeah, you have to work hard. If you think you can join. Otherwise, switch over to detailing or supervisor.
Detailing, sir.
Yeah.
Okay, sir. Thank you.
Okay. So we have reached the 5 minutes deadline I have given. If there are no questions asked, I'll close. Recording session or live interaction session? The live interaction will be there every alternate day for every batch. And recorded will be available always in YouTube. For third year, all four is okay. You can choose any one of the four. Detailing, planning, design, or supervisor. Depends on your interest, Jadav. From where we can learn making architectural plan for houses.
Hello, sir.
For making plans, you don't need plans. You need to have common sense and standards. Nikhil is asking, I feel any engineer can prepare plans very easily. It requires logic and rational and some common sense. You can make the plans. And standards, follow the standards. Hope, Nikhil, it is clear to you. Any other questions or shall we close it? planning and design are different actually. Planning is design of construction. Design is structural design actually. So that is the difference. Rahul. And Rahul. Any suggestions for second year? For second year students, my advice through this internship is to learn Excel for doing estimation and costing, and to learn AutoCAD in detail, and to make the drawings with hand. Learn to make the drawings with hand, and learn to make the estimates manually. In fact, I have trained one. I'm training one student. I don't know, Ritvika, if you are available, please come in. Ritvika. She's not available, I think. But I have trained her to test second year bar bending schedule, and she has completed one building in 3 days. So it is possible. So you can learn bar bending schedule, you can learn quantity survey, you can learn costing in second year. Yeah, Dinesh, you have any question?
Sir, for second year, if you choose supervising, it would be better, no, sir?
Yeah. That's good. Supervising, you should learn to make reports, you should learn to make minutes of meeting, learn to read contract documents, English, communication and all. Software, both STAT and ETABS are explained in design engineer thing. So thank you very much. I'll conclude if there are no other questions. So I wish you all the best. Utilize this time and make it a career for you in future. Bye. Stay safe and stay healthy. Thank you.
Hello, sir.
Yes, Sujit.
Hello, sir. I am in third year. I was registered for planning engineering. According to your opinion, which course is done for first?
No, no. Come again.
Sir, I was in third year.
Yeah.
Planning engineering, according to your opinion, which course is
to do first? Planning engineer is good for third year. Okay. I hope I answered your question.
Thank you, sir.
Well, thank you very much. Wish you all the best. Utilize this 1 month time. Somebody is entering now. I don't know. Vasant. You have any question, Vashant? Otherwise, I'm concluding closing. Somebody joined just now. Yeah, I'll communicate the schedule. If not tomorrow, maybe Friday. It will start. Yeah, good, Hemant. Wish you all the best. So I'm leaving. Bye. Have a good day.